Thanks for once again taking a few minutes to allow Jesus to refine your heart and mind by speaking into your life through His Word. Ka Min Chen from Singapore will share how Jesus' words in Matthew 13 completely rearranged what He values in life. But before we dive into his talk, Peter Furler echoes the fact that Scripture has the ability to change our lives with his song that encourages us to look to and trust Jesus no matter the circumstances.
One of the things that really changed my life was not only reading books like Matthew, but putting it into practice, you know, doing the things that it tells you to do. It works. The Bible is living and active. It's like this organism, and it moves and it does. It's why sometimes you're reading a certain scripture and a day later or 2 days later, it connects with somebody else. It was because it's living and it's moving. And, you know, Matthew 7, it talks about putting God's word into practice. And that can be easy when everything's going good. But in times of adversity, that's when it really counts. And knowing that He is a rock, that if you build your house on that rock, you can trust Him. And He will deliver exactly what needs to be done. This is a song called Lord.
It is such a comfort hearing that God knows where we're going and that the destination is good. That said, God never promises the road will be smooth or that we won't have any wrecks along the way. Ka Min Chen went through an incredibly difficult time in his career, but he found tremendous hope in a parable from Matthew chapter 13.
你一生中所看重的是什么？是金钱、名誉、地位、势力吗？这些事物，甚至是别人对你工作的认可，都不是坏事。但是我们常常过于重视这些事物，认为他们能够满足我们，然而它总是使我们渴望更多的东西。其实我们生命中最大的祝福是认识主耶稣基督，他是唯一能真正满足我们的人。在马太福音第13章44到46节中，耶稣清楚地描述了他的国度。他说，天国好像宝贝藏在地里，人遇见了就把它藏起来，欢欢喜喜地去变卖一切所有的买这块地。天国又好像买卖人寻找好珠子，遇见一颗重价的珠子，就去变卖他一切所有的买了这颗珠子。在生活中，你最看重的是什么？世人眼中所看重的宝藏是很诱人的，但耶稣对那些爱他并降服于他的人来说，是更好更大的宝藏。就如保罗在腓立比书第3章所说，我将万事当作有损的，因我已认识主耶稣基督为至宝。但是降服在今天的社会意味着什么呢？通常我们顺服上帝的旨意，以世人眼中的宝藏是完全不同的。它可能包括了世上的苦难或牺牲。也许降服是完全顺服你的掌权者，也或许降服是选择过节俭的生活，让你能够为他人慷慨接纳。也许降服意味着认识承认你不知道什么是最好的，并相信他的话语和他下一步的带领。记得几年前，当我被呼召成为代理竹林老师时，我的工作也正面临着极大的挑战。当时我被委任带领一个为期12个月的重组项目，目标是关闭我们亚太区并裁掉数百位员工，其中也包括我在内。当时我需要做个决定，选择那好的珠子，就像上人在第46节中所做出的回应，并顺从他的呼召继续侍奉他，或者相信我世俗的智慧，把一切都集中在保住工作而养家糊口。我很感恩上帝让我顺服他并回应他的呼召。带领那12个月的项目是我在公司17年职业最低点，那是一个穿越幽谷的旅程。记得我有80%的时间都在出差，向一起奋斗多年的同事传达着坏消息，但选择继续侍奉让我能够交际于他和他的话语。他的话语就是我唯一的帮助和力量。在整个过程中，上帝都在掌管与兼顾，他保守了我与我同事的关系，他也在当中扶持我，然后在适当的时间里引领我到更新更好的工作。当初如果跟随自己的智慧而不选择那个珠子，我就会错过这幽谷中经历他的信使。我不得不承认，我常常也为降服于他的国度而挣扎，但是当我选择顺服和信靠他的时候，我都会经历他所赐的平安和喜乐。那你呢？你为什么以什么方式埋葬或忘记了上帝 每天为你提供的保障，不要忘记。我们的保障不在这个世界的受造物，而处于我们的造物主阿爸父神。他差派的儿子耶稣基督来拯救我们，脱离罪恶，并将他的圣灵内住我们，在这世界里，还有什么比这个更有价值呢？
What is my treasure in life? Do I consider anything more valuable than Jesus Christ? Those are some tough questions you and I need to answer if we're going to experience all that God has for us. What God has may be difficult, even incredibly painful, but we know that whatever it is, it will eventually be the very best. Thanks for watching. You can keep the discussion going with other men every week in a BSF group. Find yours at bsfinternational.org. Like and subscribe to this video, and please come back for episode 4 when we explore Matthew chapter 26.